I was in love in 1967, and the love was going nowhere. She was a beauty. She teased me on. I don't know what was in her heart, but I knew it would have been easier to look into the sun than talk to her about my longing.
Long afloat on shipless oceans, I did all my best to smile till your singing eyes and fingers drew me loving to your isle.
I wrote lyrics to her. I extended a metaphor in old ballad form, in trochaic tetrameter, using Homer's imagery. It was just like me in the old days. I divided myself into mind and heart. I believed in my mind, and while I was scared of my heart, I was fascinated by it. I wrote my songs using my mind, but out of that fascination.
And you sang, sail to me, sail to me, let me enfold you. Here I am, here I am, waiting to hold.
The next morning, I took it to the singer at his breakfast. And he looked at it too briefly to read it. And just laid it out of the way like uninteresting mail. When his breakfast was over, he reached back for his big guitar like always and started doodling. Surprisingly, he shoved my page of words back in front of him.
Did I dream you? Dreamt about me. Were you here when I was fox? Now my foolish boat is leaning. Broken love long on your rocks.
It was like a miracle. He sang it out as though it were an old song he was composing, but the changes he made were little, as though he were only fitting the song to himself. There were two or three other friends at the round table, but not moving. It was so moving. We were all listening to that dragging, grieving melody for the first time.
For you sing. Touch me not, touch me not, come back tomorrow. Oh my heart, oh my heart, shies from the sorrow.
My lyrics had come alive, like those oriental paper flowers all folded flat, which when you drop them into a bowl of water, blossom. And his melody had found an occasion to float out of possibility into the common air. He and I always loved that song above all others we wrote. The music had a passion that was beyond my daring. The words had a clarity that was beyond his discipline. It was like a handshake of fire between one too thoughtful and one too thoughtless.
I am troubled as the tide.
together for a few years, the singer and I, symbols to each other of passion and reason. In the face of each other, we couldn't be complacent, be ourselves. We instinctively knew what Goethe taught, take into yourself that which is opposed to you. Echoing the ambiguous Greek Heraclitus, who centuries before said, it is the opposite which is good for us. We grew towards each other. Our polarities kept us apart. But across the distance, we stretched a song.
Hear me sing, swim to me. Swim to me, let me enfold you. Here I am.